Hello, everybody. Salty Walty is back. We got Rob and Jacob with us. I'm not too sure why Finn's barking. We're just going to continue on our playthrough. I don't know. It might be a short one today, like an hour, only an hour, because I'm not feeling too hot right now. So let's take a look at the Patreons. We got Brandon Markey, OA Shipper, Azrael, Kanan Maki, Casey, Sidebaster, Dragon Spark, Nerdy, Gundam Nuggers, Ibram Grant, 8863, Jeff Dunn, JJ, Clav, Maverick, Momoka, Ninja Guy 12, Peter, Strike, Tyler, Spud, Oni, Savage Shooter, Souls, Trailers, Joseph D, Alimo, Steel, Talon, Minty, Robo, Yo Boy, Burrito, Bird Person, and I don't have the new image up yet, and I can't remember the dude's name yet. Give me a second. Give or Taker. I want to thank you guys for supporting me. It does mean a lot, and let's get to it. Oh, Finn's got the zoomies. He's running back and forth all crazy like.
Oh no.
Oh. You alright, bud? Oh. Let me scratch that foot. Good boy. Alright, I guess we're. Who were we messing with last? Was it four?
Or was it someone else? I believe so.
So, what are you up to, Rob?
Mostly just. Kind of feeling like I'm behind on everything, and because the weather's changing, just been a lot of headaches the last couple of weeks. So just
dropped like 20 degrees here. You'll go back up. So.
Same here.
Yeah,
and I'm loving it.
It's really nice. Just whenever the weather changes like this, my sinuses take about a week or two to adapt. So soon I will not have this problem, but it's just taking time.
Yeah.
Fair.
I'm happy I can finally keep the windows open and not have to rely on AC anymore. It can just be, you know, a lot less power hungry now, which is great.
Yeah.
So what is the design? What's the Boundox beam rifle's design based off of? Because it sure as hell looks like a Gelgud rifle.
I mean, nothing. Look how short it is. Gotta be something that fits that claw or the hand. Which is a strong thing. Like much of the Bound Dog. Kind of its own thing.
Yeah.
Speaking of its own thing and being an asshole, how about that Tristan?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wasn't expecting it. I have it. I already have a match in it where I saved. I didn't do particularly good. I know it's melee centric, but its melee structure is so slow. And that's weird to me.
I've been...
From what I understand, it's basically just the Alex's profile from GBL1, but with port injection.
Sounds about right.
Yeah, like, from what I've heard people say, that's pretty much, it's just GBL1 Alex with a new skin and port injection. Which is interesting to me. But it's that high.
I forgot the Alex was had... a beam rifle like that in the first game, but it's been a while, so.
Oh, I just meant performance wise. I don't know about the weapons themselves, really.
Gotcha.
It's kind of Sturmfaust now, too.
Yeah.
Club.
It's not called the Sturmfaust, yeah.
Yeah.
To be honest, it looks like the Sturmfausts that are on the, like, the mobile suit in the action camper.
Yeah.
That have the little, like, triggers on them.
Mm-hmm.
Which is weird. That isn't on the camper, that's on the fucking Gundam Tide from 0096.
Yeah.
But Chronox is fucking weird, and that animation's awful. Manga's cool, story's cool. Or the novel, I mean, but, animation? Nah.
So that dude...
That's a
The man who piloted the Zaku 3, what? I don't understand how he was able to body the Tristan so fucking good.
Because he's an ace pilot, but he has a thing about killing people.
So why not, just fully disarm the gun, like, chop its arms off?
So, oh, no, like, he pretty much disarmed it and gave him the notice, and then his old came in like, nah, bruh. Nah. And he bodies that thing, pretty much.
I don't remember seeing that part. I only remember him bodying the Tristan.
So the Azold, they start shooting the roof, and, like, debris, or... asteroid debris falls on the Azul, and he's about to, like, fully disable it, and then the Azul cuts its leg off and dips.
I figure
go ahead.
Yeah. On a totally other note, I figure if they've got something that's supposed to be paired with a Biolent in the game, that kind of ups the chances we'll see the regular Biolent soonish, too.
Yeah. So, I mean, the Azul, there's regular Biolent, then there's the Azul, and then there's the two customs that are, like, on a whole other thing. The Azul is the closest thing in between the custom unit one and the regular one.
Oh, okay.
It has the customs backpack and new thrusters. Then there's the custom unit one, which has got the Gabfly claws instead of the manipulators and, like, beam machine guns. Oh, variable beam machine guns as weapons. And then the fucking Unit 2's just out there. They just took everything off everything and threw it on there. Got parts that are inspired by the Gap plant, parts that are inspired by the Bound Dock. Just a dumb amount of stuff on it. To my understanding, the expanded stuff, they dubbed the Biolent custom program the Chimera program, because they're just taking a lot of parts off Titan's special use mobile suits and just throwing it on a Biolent.
Makes sense.
I mean, I see the custom. It'll be worse good flight type, but...
Yeah.
Because it's just going to stay up there and spray. The whole time.
Then I hope they really... I hope the beam consumption was only going to be like 1%. Because that's what it does.
To be
really...
fair, that's like a literal beam machine gun.
Yeah,
that's like a literal... Like, that's not even like the Gelgud Marines rifle where it's doing a couple shots. This is literally just going.
So like,
I can see the customer, the Azul, being a raid. Regular one I'd like balance, but that could be the raid, and the Azul would be the balance, you know.
Yeah.
I need to see the Azula one.
It's the pink one. It has a Gundam face. It's pretty much the regular one, but with the customs backpack.
Oh, okay.
It's supposed to work in tandem with the Tristan, because it's the story of Tristan and Azul.
Yeah.
And also, the Tristan in the manga gets an upgrade called the Fail Knot, which is something Tristan used. I want to say it's the bow?
Okay.
And the Fail Knot looks like a prototype Vignagia.
Okay. Yeah, a lot of people were saying that in the Discord.
Yeah, so the story of Twilight Axis is supposed to be what begins bridging the gap between Unicorn and F-91.
Mm-hmm.
Twilight Axis explains where the Crossbone Vanguard gets their technology and their money.
Okay.
To start building up. Because basically, the Butch concern is the ones who clean up all the debris from the second Neo-Zeon War and the Sleeves incident.
Yeah.
Like, they were already established as a salvage company, but now they're like, man, I really like the Federation. So they steal some Jagans, they apparently get what's left of the Alex retrofitted, and they get one of the three or four known fire lamps and modify it. The Jagans they steal are basically the beginning of their distinctive eye sensor, because they put, like, the weird little eye patch sensor on. And that's the start of the goggles, I guess.
I do like that design, though. I always thought that was pretty cool looking.
I mean, for F-91 just being a glorified ripoff of Star Wars, it's pretty good. Got bad pacing, but designs are cool.
Yeah.
I do like
it.
It's basically a compilation movie for a TV show that never existed, so yeah. Pacing's not going to be a good thing there.
I love the original Crossbone Vanguard fleet designs, though. They look great. They look like actual warships. Then you get to, like, Crossbone. Gundam Crossbone. We have beam sails! Because we're pirates! Get the fuck out of here with this. But, like, the Zamas Gar and, like, the little fleet destroyers and stuff. They look cool. They got little mobile suit catapults, and they're well thought out designs. And then you get, like, say, you get the Crossbone, and it's just... The ships make no sense. There's giant space Nautilus fish. It's dumb. It's just a bad time for all.
Yeah. Nice.
That is.
I want it animated though. Everybody, why isn't Crossbone animated though, guys? Why?
You see that range? Like, the way it turned to shoot that though?
Well, yeah, because it's a bound dog. You sleep.
It looked kind of wonky.
Oh, look at the bound dog. Look at that. Little crabman. He is wonky.
God.
But he can do that.
I hope that is its counter in GBL.
So there's a lot of things they can do with the Valiant, because remember the gray one like spins its entire body around to do combos and all sorts of stuff.
Yeah. Well, I'm kind of hoping for like the Boundox counter. One of the I feel like this should be a suit that has at least two different counters for like the smaller suits. It would be like one where it uses the claw to pick it up and slam it into the ground.
Yeah,
because that claw looks like it should be able to do that.
They can't. They physically can't use most of the counter animations that they have right now, because the bound dog's so tall.
Yeah.
Like, and its feet are so disproportional. Like, they literally just can't use the kick animation because it won't fit. You'll be clipping through. It'll clip through itself. Yeah. It's. They have to do something new. Yeah, you know what else would be nice? Getting the Masala.
Yeah. I want the Masala in the game.
I mean, given they did double back to the Palace Athena, I figure we will eventually.
Finally, yeah. Man, I really hope Nuh doesn't come out this winter or spring. I hope that's next anniversary. There's so much stuff they can do in between now and then.
I got a feeling it's going to be the Nuh. I don't want it to be the Nuh, but I got a feeling.
I mean, if they're just going to speed rush to Unicorn, and then they said they were going to stop there, it's not like they're going to add F90 stuff unless they change their mind.
Yeah. I figure a lot of that...
Oh, you go ahead.
I figure a lot of that depends on whether or not the game gets carried over to PS5.
It's going to.
Yeah, since there's so much crossplay already, I don't know if there'll be, like, a quote-unquote HD version, or literally just them making it work on a PS5.
Yeah.
That'll probably happen, but I mean, you figure GBL was, this was the second anniversary, right, that just happened?
Yeah.
I mean, you figure GBL1 lasted 3 or 4?
It was 5 years.
Yeah.
5?
Yeah.
So we're only really, we're not even halfway through the life expectancy of the game yet.
Yeah.
I like the Masala. What a cool looking design.
Not really been a ton after like the RG Zeong getting fully revealed and the Wing Verka having a shield and everyone's like, what the fuck? It has a bird mode.
Yeah, I've seen that. I was like, it looks sharp though. It really does.
So this is Kotoki being like, you know what, the Angel Wing stuff, it was kind of stupid, and it doesn't transform, so I'm going to fix that. So now it's going to have Angel Wings and transform. The Wing has to have one of the worst transformations.
Yeah.
So I'm going to flip my torso around 180 degrees and somehow magically put the shield on my back. Like, at least the Zetas is overly complicated, but makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Wayne's like, nah, bro, I'm gonna contort myself, not to fly. I don't remember when the new Battlelog stuff was supposed to come out, but they put all the old Battlelog stuff back on Gundam Info.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh. You guys see that, the Nuh Real Great Zeong?
Yeah, I brought that up first. Yeah, it's looking good.
That is looking sharp, I'm not gonna kid. Plus all the firing, the really neat looking firing effects to come with it.
And they have the last shooting combo pack that comes with the Gundam and the Zeong.
Oh, do they?
And special effect parts just for that scene.
Oh, nice.
So yeah, there's Nuh parts for the Gundam that lets us hold its beam rifle. Different, so I can shoot straight up, and then the Zeong's got some Nuh effect parts to the head.
I'm gonna have to check that out. I didn't see that part.
So, P-Pandai, perfect Zeong win.
Mm-hmm.
We're already there.
There you go.
What a solid series this thing is. Hey, Ashmar, what's up, bud?
It's still pretty good in Maxi Boost, too. Maxi Boost and Versus both. Solid.
Nice.
Just... Well, you're getting there.
Yep. Ooh. Oh, okay.
So, speaking of half-assed stuff, like playing this Grublow just underwater, versus, or Maxi Boost added 1v1s, and did it in the most back-ass-words way possible.
Really?
Yeah, so you know how 1v1s in regular Versus was like, you just click on the 1v1 mode, and it's kind of a shuffle, and just whoever match made you get in the match with?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, this is basically the team free, and you can only fight people who are on your team. So Team A can only fight Team A, Team B can only fight Team B.
That's weird.
Yeah, no, it's very half-assed. Which, granted, this is an old game, but
yeah,
that needs to be implemented better. Like, definitely. That's bad. Everyone saw that, and they're and also, 1v1s do not count for any trophy.
Well, that's kind of dumb.
Yeah, they don't want people going out there and farming out their wins and stuff. Like, no, you have to do it in 2v2. The Grublow.
This thing's dumb. This thing was a bitch to fight in Senki, though. I hated fighting this thing.
Yeah.
I just now realized that this thing in the big row has the pretty much the same design.
Same design.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Grublow is listed, I think, as a variant of the big row, and it's also its model number is 1 after.
I did not know that.
Instead of being MA, it's like what MAN for or MAM for Marine. It's instead of MA06, it's MAM07.
I'm coming back now. This thing is so stupid.
Yeah, the Grublow is kind of weird.
Fuck it. Let's go. So the Bolonok Saman's buffs are pretty good.
Yeah,
they needed to be.
I mean, they're hella solid now. I haven't used it since the buff, but, like, I've fought a few. They're not fun to fight.
No, they're pretty tough.
I'm just waiting. I'm waiting for the buff where it gives them a level 2 stealth.
Yeah.
Because that, it really don't need it. I don't understand why they decided to give the Desert Gelgo level 2 stealth, because it was doing just fine with level 1.
I don't know.
I thought I would have stacked forward.
Oh yeah, did you guys see the new developer newsletter that came out the last
couple
days?
Water should be this week.
Yep.
Hopefully.
I'm excited.
The new map is just Jaburo outside, pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, they show a ground Gundam. I guess it could be, like, one of the places in Southeast Asia that HMS team went.
Really. Yeah.
That caught my head. But it's either Jaburo outside or, like, somewhere in Southeast Asia.
I don't know if I'm going to stay up for the update, but I'm really looking forward to it.
I probably will. I mean, I just about always do at this point, so.
I will.
And it definitely worked out this last week, so.
Yeah, Tristan out of nowhere.
Yeah, you busted that Tristan out, and like, you know what? Live commentary time. Here we go, boys.
Yeah, that went that did really well.
Oh boy.
And I'm happy. I'm happy it went as well as it did, and that everybody liked it as much as they did, because like I said, I have not done that during GBO2 in forever, so. I think the last time I tried to play and talk live was during the tutorial, doing the tutorials like 2 years ago, so.
I had to fix my headset there for a second.
Gotcha. But, Yeah, and I just like using Tristan. Like I said, it's just about perfectly suited to how I play, so.
Good. I haven't got it yet. I've rolled a fair bit for it, and I haven't got it. Bumped me out.
Oh, fingers crossed, because, yeah, I enjoy it.
I mean, since I know this is the water update, I'm not really expecting a ton to be, like, they're going to be an aquatic suit, probably. So I'm guessing Banner's Kapool, and we'll have a mission mode suit for the Aqua Gym, is my guess.
That will work fine for me, so.
Well, there's a weekly mobile suit we can get. Hopefully it's the Zaku Mariner or the Aqua Gym.
Yeah. I'm feeling Aqua Gym.
Oh yeah, I also got the Night Seeker 2 this week.
Oh, have you tried it yet?
Yeah, it is not bad. It's, to be honest, I feel like I'm a little bit more comfortable using the standard light armor than I am that, but it is good. It took me a little bit to get just like comfortable with it, but
yeah.
It's just one of those things that has, you know, it has a ton of sub weapons for 250.
How do you feel that it's dual Uzis are technically better than the Pixies dual Uzis?
I'm kind of not surprised, but I always kind of liked the Pixies machine gun, so I don't really mind how they are. The only thing I'd really do to them is maybe speed up their reload a little bit. But...
See, it had a good reload when it was originally released, but like they nerfed it for whatever reason.
Yeah.
No one understands why they nerfed those Uzis, because, to be fair, they weren't even strong when the game was released.
No, they weren't. They weren't strong at all. But still ran the 90 even when I got it.
Yeah.
Like, because the 90s was better.
And then they nerfed them even more, which caused, like, you never see a Pixie run its ranged weapons at all. It's always just have beam sabers out.
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand why with higher levels the Pixie don't get no better stealth. It's always at level 1.
Yeah, I thought
it was kind of the first stealth suit, and really the Pixie shouldn't have stealth unless it's wearing its cloak, and the cloak's not in game.
Hmm.
Like the only, and that wasn't on every Pixie either. It was like Pixie Unit 2 had the cloak.
Yeah.
So it's like, that's just something they put in games, like, oh, Pixie's stealthy because one of them was stealthy that one time when it's wearing something.
Mm-hmm.
Oof. Oh, I had that new Patreon I just got, Taker Giver. He had a request for me, which surprised me, but I was happy to fulfill. Was Recon Zaku in Titans colors, which was the beige and brown colors.
Yeah.
Turned out nice.
It you can actually do it in the game, and it looks really good. I was so happy with how it turned out. It looks so
nice. Fantastic.
And apparently the Recon Zaku is in Thunderbolt, and it has this fuck-off huge gun. And I don't know if it's a shooting-type gun, or is it just a stupidly long-range camera.
Probably just a big-ass camera.
That really makes no sense. That, like, just give it a standard Zaku head at that point.
I don't know, bro. What about Thunderbolt standard?
I don't know. I'm not a fan of the designs in Thunderbolt. Right in the chest. Boom. Love the Gatplant.
Yeah, that's good. Can't wrap my head around it in GBO, but it's good.
Stay back and just shoot.
That's what I do, but I just feel like I'm wasting like half the suit's potential.
Yeah. That's what I use. I just stay back and shoot, because for one, I'm terrible at melee, unless I'm in the GOG. But, I just shoot and pick on any raid, I mean, support that I can see.
Works.
Fucking Seventh Gundams really hate seeing a Gatplant coming around the corner.
Yeah.
Oh, That looks so fucking cool.
No, you look cool.
Oh, thank you. I don't have these capture colors in the video yet.
What capture colors?
For the Galgood, for the red shield and all that.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Or just gives basically like a gem colored shield.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I forgot. That's a. Psycho Gundam can't go on buildings.
Nope. Break them. Too big. Too beefy.
Yeah, I'm still a little upset with GBO how they gave us the second boss fight is just the Psycho Gundam with better helpers.
Yeah.
It's
a little annoying, but.
Hopefully they'll add some new stuff soon.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully it's like the Psycho Gundam 2 or just something.
Big Zam.
Yeah.
I'd be all down for
Big Zam would be fine. Grublo for underwater.
Yeah.
Be fine.
They're gonna have to make a big enough map, though, for the Grublo.
I mean, they can. Just basically take that new map, fill it all with water, and have, like, one little dock on one side for the ships that aren't.
Why are you so short?
Because he's a regular mobile suit and you're a Psycho Gundam.
So I was doing some research. The prototype Psycho Gundam is actually a Mark II. And it's...
Yeah, it was based on the Mark II's frame, but swelled up. Yeah,
yeah, it's just thick. Because it's got the Psycho Commune system on its back. And then it can't fire its Mega Particle Cannon without overheating for 10 seconds.
Okay.
It can't move for 10 seconds after firing. It can't fire move after firing essentially that. I wouldn't mind like a Crossfire-esque game if it dealt with that one into like Zeta era.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not something that they couldn't do. It's just it's a lot of effort and Bandai probably wouldn't give them the money.
Yeah. As you and me have said, Jacob, Crossfire needed at least 2 to 3, about 4 or 5 more months in the oven, and it would have been a good game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if they would have fixed them fucking textures breaking apart at every second.
Yeah. I still
have... God, that one's so annoying. I hate that texture one so bad.
I still have
I'll take the terrible English voice acting. Yeah, no, it's still fine. I'll take the English, the terrible English voice acting, but the fucking texture's breaking apart every time you like walk through a building or something. Like, nah.
That was such a fun game, especially I wonder how they're gonna do DOMS because BB Studios is the same company that worked on Crossfire and Crossfire
no,
DOMS. Yeah,
they worked on Side Stories.
No, they worked in.
They did.
Yeah. And they had DOMS hover over water, so I'm wondering if they're gonna have DOMS and GBO hover over water.
That's something they have avoided, isn't it?
Yeah.
What, DOMS hovering over water?
Yeah, they haven't shown.
Yeah, in animation. But like, in Crossfire, that's what they did. That's why I like...
Yeah, no, I remember.
Yeah, so...
Hmm. Wait, who is this? Oh, Mar?
Yeah, so now she's alive.
Yeah. Just for you.
It's the best suit. Like, Kakarot 197, my boy, put out a video showing how much stronger those megaparticle cannons in his arms are than regular beam rifles. It's double the power of the Oath beam rifle.
Oh, wow.
Like, everyone's like, oh, it's underarm. Nah, it's putting out fat damage. Fat. And also, you gotta realize, like, oh, hey, it's not very armored. What suit in Zeta's armored?
Yeah.
None of them. Only Double Zeta gets armor.
Just most of them just get a light coating of anti-beam, and that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I saw a video today of, like, it's a skinny cat standing on its hind legs, Zeta Gundam. Big, fat, obese cat, Double Zeta Gundam. And it's correct.
Oh, you guys remember the meme cat, Long Cat?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I heard.
Passed away.
Yeah.
18 years old. Pretty good for a cat.
Oh, yeah.
I think you know that white screen cat, like the perfectly cut screen cat?
Yeah.
The white one, big fluffy one. I think it's dead too.
Yeah.
Waffles. Thurston Waffles. Shame.
Kubosu died, was it last year?
The dog?
Yeah, Doge.
Yeah.
They're living mortally in memes.
I don't know how I'd have a, Alright, yeah, here's a question. If you guys had your own Byron, how would you customize it?
Pretty much just a custom, but maybe add regular manipulators instead of the gap-play claws. Because the Unit 2 actually has regular manipulators. So a custom Unit 2.
And I don't know if I would. I kind of like the base model. I might just leave it like that.
I think what I would do the same as Jacob. I would use the base model, not use a custom. Give it standard manipulators just in case I need to grab a gun. But the main difference is mine would probably just, you know, pack some missiles up in there.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that thrust attack. I forgot how good that is.
Wait, so who's in the Psycho Gundam? I'm war now. Never mind.
Yeah.
I seem to recall when you have to kill large targets, you can loop that lunge attack pretty easily.
That I wouldn't know, because I never care for using the suit.
I remember getting a lot of mileage out of that when I played, but it's been forever, so the specifics are kind of lost to me.
Is it supposed to have, like, a Gundam-esque head? And the visor's in the way?
What? No, it's got a mono-eye. Oh. The Byerlant?
Yeah.
No, yeah, it's got a mono-eye. You can see it in the model viewer. It's just blocked by that visor for some reason. I think the visor's a little bit too big in this game.
Jared, I'll protect you.
Not for long. I gotta give the Gabathy another go. I haven't used it since the buff.
It's like one of... I think it's the only Zeta suit I do not have at the moment.
Oh, I still don't have a Rick Diaz.
It is good.
Yeah, you're all over the place with the Rick Diaz in today's match. And I was like, damn, he would probably kick my ass in space. I'm not even kidding. Like, you were, like, damn. I was really impressed.
That was a really good round in space. I'm actually going to be running another space round the next couple of days, because I just gave the Tristan a run in space to see how it went. And it went really well until I screwed the whole round up at the very end.
How did you manage that?
I got myself killed at the last second and lost the game.
Oof.
Yeah, like, one of those things where I knew I was making a mistake at the time, I just was not really sure how I could disengage safely, and answer is I couldn't, so.
But yeah.
That's most of the mistakes I make in this game. I do something stupid and go, well, I'm committed.
You don't think it'd be that way, but sometimes it just be.
Oh yes, yep. It definitely do.
We were playing some dailies. Was it Thursday, Jacob? Or is it Wednesday? I don't remember. I think it was Thursday. But we had a couple of viewers come in and just extra people from the Discord. So I ended up hitting random. Me and one of the patrons, Brandon Markey.
Was it Tuesday?
Was it Tuesday?
Mm-hmm.
Me and him were on the enemy side world. The opposing team was Jacob and a bunch of other people from the Discord, and we only lost by 95 points.
Oh wow.
Like me and Brandon Markey, we had to stick together and double team. I posted that match yesterday.
Oh, nice.
You give a watch any of those three I gave you?
I'm actually going to be running one of the ones you gave me either tomorrow or Tuesday, so.
Nice.
Yeah.
I'm happy they helped.
I appreciate it, because like I said, I've just been behind on everything lately.
I think so. I got some more, but I need to make sure, like, my party chat audio didn't get captured.
I talking. Gotcha.
We brought up RD again while I was doing those. Oh, good time.
Can't believe he has the audacity to say he's kicked Heavy's ass.
I'm surprised he hadn't hit me back up since 1v1's are in now. Honestly surprised.
Oh, why the fuck my beam shoot straight up like that?
Yeah, Heavy still got his belt too. Never forget.
Spit polish that thing every day, he does.
Oh, yeah, it was fun. They were yesterday, so everyone was talking about, like, the Call of Duty beta and just a bunch of stuff on there. So there was a lot of expletives flying. Artie was not the only one. We were pretty much talking shit about everybody, including people in the party. So I just don't make sure that's not captured on the video.
I gotcha.
To be honest, I played the beta and I wasn't really impressed.
So that's the first COD game I've played since Big Red 1 and I hated it, so I haven't touched COD in like a decade. So
I
did that as a favor to a friend.
I'm probably just going to stick with Modern Warfare, but they really cool down on them updates. Each update being like, you know, 50, 60, 70.
20 gigabytes?
Yeah, you know, 70 gigs and up.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's pretty bad.
There are so many things I just have not installed on either computer or PS4 at the moment just because of the size of them.
Yeah.
Well, COD's horrible about it. COD is like the largest game on PlayStation. COD is like pushing 200 gigabytes.
It's past 200 gigabytes if I'm
not
mistaken.
Okay, it's past 200.
I would
like,
have to...
what other games are 200 gigabytes on a console?
I mean, we have PlayStation Plus, and I was kind of interested in Street Fighter V, but it's like 30, 40 gigabytes, I think, just for Street Fighter.
Yeah, but like, again, that's like 30, 40. Like, oh god, this is 220. Like, boy, and that's what I mean. COD is going to be the benchmark for roughly how big all next generation games are. In terms of size, and the PlayStation 5 only has like 800 gigabytes of storage.
Yeah, that's not going to work out very well.
Go buy that external SSD, boys. It's only $220 or something like that. Good thing the digital one's cheaper, because God, I'm going to have to buy an external one. It's going to make me sad.
Yeah.
Well, see, now...
Well, they said the SSD drives we get for the PS4 will work on the PS5.
Only for PS... Well, those are just external hard drives. They're not SSD.
Yeah.
Those are just external. They work, but only for PS4 games.
Okay.
That's for backwards compatibility. The way it's always been explained to me is that, like, you can just plug that right in, it's gonna work, and all your PS4 games that are digital, you can do them right there.
I'm fine with that, then.
Yeah, but, like... new game? Nah. I think the PS5 might not let it do it because it's selling itself on not having load times. And if they were to use an external like that, it would probably spin it too fast and start damaging it, and also there would be load times.
Yeah.
I'm going to want to upgrade this a bit.
But,
I'm looking forward to that water update.
Yep.
Ah!
It's gonna be fun.
And newsletter said that next month they're going to apparently be refining the controls in some way, which should be interesting. So.
Okay, so I didn't see that part. Do they mean for the water combat or just controls in general?
In general is how it reads.
Hey,
it says,
as long as they make dodge roll priority over force injection, I'm all for it.
Yeah. But yeah, it says in the next developer newsletter, Convey will report on improvements in controls, so be sure to look out for that as well. I like the idea in principle, and I'm also just kind of thinking, okay, well, I'm about to be fighting against, like, 8 years of muscle memory here.
Yeah. Well, and one thing that might be improvement to control might just be mobile armor, or translatable mobile suit control, too. That might, because that they all handle, like, ass.
Yeah, or they could be refining the space controls again.
Yeah, that'd be nice. I don't think they'll touch ground, because, like you said, ground is too touch. Like, unless they change priority, like, dodge roll takes priority over force injector.
Yeah,
I'd
take that.
But yeah.
We'll see. I'm looking forward to this water update. We need more amphibious suits because we don't have a ton.
Yeah.
We have a lot of levels of them. We just don't have a ton of different ones.
Yeah.
The gogs are going to be even scarier now. Gogs have always been just wobbling around on ground, smacking the hell out of people. So now, they'll be fast in water, and you're like, oh no, fast gog.
Mm-hmm.
Fast gog is it real? Fast gog can't hurt you. GBO2 update.
I like how the marine mobile suits essentially get stealth in water.
Yeah, they should. That's the point of it. That's the point why they're submersible is for stealth.
Mm-hmm.
Does the act guy get double stealth?
Apparently.
It just goes out of the game map. Just you can't even see it. It's just done.
It fucking God damn. The what do you call that mode in Gmod? No clips through the ground.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. For those who still play Gunna Breaker Mobile, that's getting a big update. To listen to the recording. They're just finishing their anniversary. So their anniversary started like a week before GBO2's, and they're just wrapping up all the stuff from the anniversary.
Wow.
Yeah, they did a lot. We got the Tri-Age Magnum as our free suit this week.
Nice.
So not the one from Build Fighters, or Build Divers, but the one from the Tri-Age card game, which is the one the Build Divers one is based off of. It's the P-Bandai kit.
With actual cards.
Well, that's the regular release kit. We got that. The big thing now is one of the side characters is getting a new mobile suit, and they're gonna give it out to everybody once you complete like the story. So, so it's like a custom F91, and it looks great.
Nice.
It's pink though. Pink fixes that, but pink. It's like a Zold pink even. But with. I've been enjoying that 76 update, Salty.
It's alright. Still lacking. From what I heard, they combined the two DLCs for the Brotherhood of Steel into one.
So they would. So it would all come out this year. Yeah.
Yeah.
Which, that's good, because that's the main thing they've been leading up for like 6 months now.
Yeah.
So I can't wait.
Oh, yeah, but the bad thing about that is they moved all the story stuff forward, but all the quality of life shit and, like, new UI got moved back.
Yep.
Oh.
So we're going to get all, like, we're going to get all the story quests and all that, and it's going to be, like, hours and hours and hours of gameplay, but, like, perk loadout, the expeditions, stuff like that, all got moved to 2021. But Daily Ops is, for those who play
fun.
Destiny, yeah, those who play Destiny, it's basically a strike, and it's super fun. And unfortunately, because the Brotherhood of Steel stuff got moved forward, the new game mode for Daily Ops got moved to 2021. So we just have Uplink until 2021.
Oops.
It's still fun, though. Uplink's pretty
good. Oh, yeah. No, it's still good time.
Real good at getting legendary gear, too.
Yeah, best
nice.
Place to play it. I got both the weapons right now. That can drop its plans. One of them I'm like, oh cool, this is nice. The other one I'm like, this is hot garbage. Why is this even in here? Whistle in the Dark is a nocturnal assault rifle, and those who know Fallout 76 know nocturnal stuff sucks.
Yep.
It also weighs like 20 pounds. Ooh. Nah, it's like 50, but it's heavy. No good.
Yeah, there's... Well, they did change the Assassin's Perk finally, which I'm insanely happy about.
And bloody builds are now have their damage is down, and their flaw is definitely more exploitable now.
Yep.
From enemies. So it's a nerf to them and they need it. But then, like, people are still making a joke, oh, well, my build used to do 8,000 damage, and now it only does 4K. Like, it still one-hit everything.
Mm-hmm. But now they get one-hit by everything.
Yeah. So I was like, oh, man, I invested so much, and I just, like, dude, that's still 10 times more damage than most enemies take, period. Just silly. And it's easier to level up now, just overall... It's easier to get gear that you need. It's a good update. Like,
yeah.
It's probably the best update they've ever had. In terms of, like, fixes and game mechanic fixes, and it's probably the best one they've ever had. Took them 2 years, but they did it.
Yeah. The whole level up one is my favorite, where the enemies are now your level.
Yeah, so I don't have to make a new character just to do the level up challenge.
Yep.
Legendary perks are alright. They got overhyped, but I think they offer good utility.
Oh, that double, the ammo smith.
The ammo factory one's the best one. Yeah, by far. That and Master Infiltrator, if you have like a new character, you just automatically get +3 pick lock, +3 hacking.
Yeah.
Automatically.
More dead.
Hella dead.
Yep.
You know why you lost
still
that?
Up under me? Yes, you are.
Didn't use Byron.
Duh. I wonder how they're gonna make that thing fit in the maps.
Yeah, I mean, there's only a couple of them that's gonna be the problem.
I see City gonna be a problem.
Ruined City's a problem. The Bone Oak Samhan already struggles in Ruined City.
I forget what it is. I'm getting stuck on some of the girders and things in the port base these days.
Yeah. Well, port base about to get that heavy overhaul.
Well,
yeah.
No, it's going to be a sub map.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It's going to be an optional map, so the old port base will still be available.
Which is kind of dumb, if you ask me.
I don't mind it, but
port base is a lot of people's favorite map, and they didn't want to be like, okay, this one's done. Gone forever.
Yeah, they are adding water to the city on a ruined city on a permanent basis, but since it's just a fairly shallow stream, like they said, it shouldn't change like the gameplay too completely.
Yeah.
No. Just like, hey, I probably shouldn't cross this bridge because there's a dog down there. I'm just gonna not go that way.
I can't.
All it does is protect base bombing, which is fine. For that.
I just can't wait.
Isn't the sub map version of Fort Base adding more to it too? Like some of that water that's in between the two Himalaya classes you can go in?
That I don't know. I hope so.
Not sure.
That'd be cool. Then Gog just get on a Himalaya craft and zip across to the other one. Just like haha. But yeah, we need more aquatic suits.
I hope we get the Aqua GPO 1.
Yeah, that'd be interesting.
Oh, yeah.
We do have a suit from Rebellion already. Hmm. Oh, and also, I was looking at Gundam Wiki today. I guess in Rebellion, one of the Gelgud Marine Commander types gets a railgun.
What the fuck?
Okay. I guess when Seema is, like, taking over the, what's the Lozian class called? The Gwadin?
Don't remember.
I think. So it's sitting on top of that while Gato's coming over with the Noizeal, and it just shoots around right through its shoulder, getting past the eye field and everything. And he's just like, oh, okay. So he kind of stops there, and that's where the panel ends, so I don't know anything more. But yeah, gets a big old railgun.
Okay.
I kind of want to see that now.
Yeah.
It's not a very big round, which makes sense, because like railgun projectiles are actually very small in diameter. So it just shoots a round right through his shoulder, and he's like, hmm. It's not SEMA piloting it, because at that point, SEMA has the Gabara Tetra. I don't, this might be a new character for Rebellion. It's piloting her old commander type.
Yeah. How's that looking, boss? He's like, yo, what's up?
Look at it go. Watch him give us the Gaza D.
Yeah.
No, not even related to water. Gaza D. Who will roll for that? Ooh. I'm about to skip that. I'm burnt out on the Tristan. Even if I had like 100 tokens, I wouldn't go roll for no damn Gaza D. Got worm. I do it.
Yeah, I want the guys.
Guys a D. Yeah, guys a D. Nah. Is it stuttering for you, Rob?
A little bit.
Okay. Gotta make sure that wasn't my internet.
No, I don't think it is.
I did hit F9. If I need to hit F9 again, let me know.
No, that was just, it just slowed down.
Yeah, so far it's good.
Oh.
Watch Mojo ranked Hathaway the eighth most anticipated anime movie to come out at some point soon. Random gunners. They really don't like Hathaway. That makes that abundantly clear. They must be running out of video ideas. They have to. How do they make one every day?
Roberto, stop being so evasive.
What do you think of other Gunpla news and stuff? New F90 packs, again. I think they're over halfway through the alphabet now.
Oh, nice.
Well, they're going. They're gonna go. They're gonna get all 26 packs, even the ones they had to make up, like the U pack. I'm waiting for the big box set where you get like one F90 and then the 26 pack for like $300. But to be honest, that would be bad, but you'd have so much leftover parts. So many leftover parts.
Someone brought it up to me, like, why did you switch from Warhammer to 40K when it comes to model build? And I'm like, well, Gunpla's actually cheaper.
Yeah.
And that's a set.
Game
Master
Workshop
grades.
Price gouges the shit out of their stuff.
Oh, yeah.
No, Game Workshop has been terrible about that for decades. Even I've known about that.
Oh, yeah. We used to have a Game Workshop shop around here, and just the prices were ridiculous.
Forge World. Their official. Not the old 90s Forge World that was just some guy. No, the actual Forge World. Where they're selling model kits for thousands of dollars. Yeah. And it's not even a complete one.
Wow.
You have to buy the weapons for it separate, and they're like 200 apiece.
Jeez.
Like the body of the Warlord class Titan. Just the body. Not in the head. Just the body. That is $2,500.
Yeah, no head, no arms, no legs, no weapons. $2,500. That's a car.
Yeah.
Games Workshop can eat it.
Yeah.
It's not even painted. The new Gundam with no funnels was cheaper than that, and it's painted, made out of metal.
Really pretty looking model though.
And now they're coming out with a $200 option parts pack for it with petite mobile suits and cranes and shit,
oh,
and a new beam rifle, I think. But yeah, no. That's price gouging the shit out of stuff. At least that's metal and painted.
Mm-hmm.
So what is y'all's favorite mobile suit to use in GBL right now? What do you feel like if you need... If you want to have fun, but need a win also, what is the thing you go to the most?
Depends on the cause.
Yeah.
Say 450.
450? Probably... Probably still the early production Gelgoog. If I want to enjoy myself and need the win, that's probably going to be it.
I like donking people with the Pale Rider's gun. I play it in 500 now a lot, too, actually.
Nice. Yeah, sometime soon I'm actually going to have a round that went really well in Vish Donahue's Gelgoog, because I had a patron ask me to recommend them a Gelgoog that was good for medium to short range, and I think the Vish Gelgoog is pretty perfect for that.
That is the perfect suit for that.
Yeah.
There's a new Mercurius and V8 C-Bandai kit that's based off the new Leo.
Oh yeah, I heard about
the
that.
The combo kit. They look good.
Yeah.
There's that, all that new Hello Kitty stuff. Which apparently sold like hotcakes when it was Gundams and other Zaku. Let's see. Here.
I think the one
Oh, there's that Lightning Striker pack that's coming out for, what are the Robot Damashii Metal Build stuff?
Not sure.
No, I mean, it's like the Strike, and they're coming out with a bunch of packs for it. And they brought the Lightning Striker pack out, and everyone's like, what the fuck is that? Like, no one knows what it is, and it... There is a Master Grade coming, too, but it's China exclusive. And it's like,
that's odd.
Yeah, it's being painted red. That was never painted red. I don't know why they picked the Lightning Striker as the Master Grade to do it, but whatever.
Yeah.
They're re-releasing that Freedom kit, the one with all the effect parts, the model kit. They've got a new version, and they're re-releasing the effect part kits for it. So if you're into Seed and don't have that already.
Yeah.
Of course, the RG Zeong we already covered.
The mobile suit I like to
the entry grade stuff.
Yeah.
They're coming out like little bionicle, like plastic containers, and there's like a Castball Gundam and regular Gundam double pack.
Oh, nice.
That's cool.
They look like little bionicle cases. It's like, what? Which they're only like $7, so they're about the price of a bionicle, used to be.
Yeah.
Man, I really don't have a leg to stand on here.
Oh my god, Sulfur. It took me a second.
Actually, I wanted them to destroy my other part and see what else gets replaced. I don't know. Oh, her head?
Okay. Your head?
Yes. I was kind of hoping it was going to be the other leg. That'd be kind of cool. But yeah, I think the suit I like the most at 450 when I need to pull out a win, but have fun at the same time, Kaizak Custom. Because I do straight nasty shit with that thing.
Another one of that cost is the Uma Gelgoog.
Oh yeah, that's
when everyone starts modding for beam around 450 and it has no beam.
Mm-hmm.
It's all physical.
That missile pod, it gets a straight nasty.
Yeah. Both of them. The one on the arm and the big anti-ship one.
Yeah.
Because everyone sleeps on that little one, but they hit you like four times, you're stunned.
Yeah.
And then just opens you up.
Plus its downswing is beautiful.
Yeah.
Love that downswing.
Yeah, it's a good one. A good one.
I'm launching.
You know what I like? I bet that style ticket that they're selling for GBO2 barely sold anything.
Probably.
That's the stupidest addition they've ever made to GBO2. They just added the Tristan. Like, I like how we skipped 8 years, too.
Well, technically, it was, from what I'm understanding, was built during the Zeta era.
I know, but its first appearance in anything is 0090s.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, actually, during the little story mode for the box in GBO, it states it was seen battle during Zeta era.
Hmm.
See, they say that, but like I said, like, this is all stuff that came out after the fact. Like, this is after the model kit. That wasn't even on the model kit.
Yeah.
This is, like, stuff from the manga, like, retconning stuff. Like, its first appearance is 0096. Like, we jumped from 88 to 96. We jumped over Unicorn. We jumped over Shark's Counter Attack. We jumped over... Well, is Narrative 97? Or is that also 96?
I think 96, but I could be entirely wrong.
So I know, like, Twilight Axis is, like, October or later of 96.
Hmm.
Because they specify it's late 96, they don't want to give it a month. Narrative might be 97. Oh, God, I don't want the Phoenix added. If they keep all the space bullshit out, like space magic, I'm fine. The Phoenix will be fine.
Yeah.
That cool stuff. If like they give the new Gundam a Psycho Frame attack instead of just it being a mode, like, and same thing for the Unicorn, they give it a Psycho Frame attack, like a sub weapon. That's stupid. Because then you're gonna have the fucking Phoenix out here karate chopping time. It did it! It did a judo chop and shot time at somebody.
I know.
Like,
okay.
I did the big Austin Powers judo chop and shot time at somebody. Or reverse time. I don't fucking know. Space magic, stupid. Also, there's like a bunch of versions of the narrative they could add, I guess. They're waiting for it. I imagine they'll stop it. Like, I can't see them if they do keep going. I can't see them going past Hathaway. I can see them ending in Hathaway just because it'll still be fresh in people's minds. Because probably the third movie won't be out for another 2 years.
Yeah.
But I can't see them going to the micro mobile suits. That would be weird. Nope, 97 is narrative. So yeah, it's after. So we're in between Unicorn and narrative right now. Oh no. Salty just wants his big, thick Gustav Karl.
Yeah, actually, I do want that. It looks cool. Yeah.
We all want that. Gustav Karl gonna chat it up, being big.
I would shit, like... If we got the Journey to Jaburo Zoc next week.
Zoc upgrade specification or whatever it would be called. Like I said, it shows up in MSVR as like a paper machine that never got off the drawing board. They have it in the background. It's like big Zoc, clearly the Journey to Jaburo blueprint.
Yeah.
So I guess that brings it into some sort of loose canon there because manga's from video game. But...
That thing was a beast in that game, Journey to Jaburo. That thing was stupid strong.
Well, yeah, because it would have to be, because the real one got in a 10-second fight. The one in Journey to Jaburo face grabs the Gundam and fucking yeets it across a cave.
Rob, did you ever play
Journey to Jaburo? Its intro cutscene is longer than 10 seconds.
Yeah, I did have that one. I remember finishing it, but again, that was...
That game has not aged well.
I can believe it.
Not graphically. I'm talking about control, like control-wise. That game handled like ass.
That game has not aged well, period. Graphically, it's bad for the time even then. And even though it's like a launch title for PS2, it's bad for them.
Yeah.
The controls don't use the analog stick unless you turn them on.
Yeah.
No, even with, if you turn them on,
and
they
it
didn't work.
Controls terribly with the analog stick, yeah. Better to just use the face button. Encounters in Space has aged well both graphically for its time and control-wise, thankfully. Since it's a direct sequel. But yeah, Journey to Jaburo, if you're going to replay that now, the best thing about it is all the cutscenes. Because they're all, like, new animations for the time. But that has come out, like, right when they started production for the U.S. version of Gundam.
Mm-hmm.
So the script is still very direct translation, but all the voice actors are right.
Yeah.
Like, instead of saying, Miss Matilda, I'm confused, Bright's out here, Miss Matilda, I'm puzzled. It's like, and there's, like, a big deadpan face, and then he keeps talking. So, like, yeah, it's, like, very early scriptage. Definitely not as refined as, like, the final cut would be. But it's a lot of it's new animation. It's got a cool intro cutscene for the mission mode that has, the white base crew, the blue Destiny, the white Dingo Jim, and a ground Gundam. And the Alex.
Yeah. I just hated how...
The blue Destiny's catching, like, in Jaburo, catching the Char punch. Like, it's like Char went to go punch the blue Destiny instead, and it's like, nah. Caught. Which was kind of funny.
I really hated how stiff the animations were.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and Journey to Jaburo?
Yeah.
Awful. Only we were in space. Like I said, the best thing about Journey to Jaburo is the cutscene. Like, that's it. Like, at this point, that would be the only reason you would replay it, if you get those cutscenes. Because, like, the block button... It... So your mobile suit doesn't have a camera control. I mean, it has a free look mode, but then it snaps back to that. The only thing that controls your mobile suit is its targeting reticle. So if you're not boosting the turn, like, you stop your momentum, take, like, 3 steps to turn to, like, the left or right, and then keep going. Like, it's really bad. It feels clunky as shit. But it's also from the year 2000, I think. So, it's old.
Yeah.
Gun tanks hit
like that
really hard in the game.
Yeah. Yeah, they one-hit your shield. Which, one cool thing about that game I'll give them credit for, if your mobile has a shield and it gets destroyed, not only does it destroy your shield, it destroys your shoulder on that side.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah.
Like, the shoulder armor comes off and stuff, which is kind of cool. The Zaku can actually use its shield in that mode.
Yep.
Not a very good shield, but you can use it. The gun cannons just use their arms, which, that works. Big armor. Doms are pretty scary in that game, too, because they're, like, one of the final enemies.
Yep.
So they made it super tough.
Alex was not that good in that game.
No, it wasn't. Considering its Vulcan was, like, a special attack or stupid shit.
Oddly enough, the white Dingo Jim was better.
Yeah. The ground gun wasn't terrible, except for that rifle it had.
Yeah. Its melee was,
Well, and the other cool thing about that game is we've talked about before how you can change your paint jobs by doing button inputs.
Yep.
You get, like, secret paint jobs. Because the Gundam has, like, the G3, the prototype Gundam, and then, like, a weird anniversary paint job that has, like, Kido Senshi Gundam written on the shield.
It looked good.
Yeah, it looked good.
I'll look up that paint scheme and see if I can copy it into GBO.
I mean, I could probably get some pictures for you, but it, like, the camera mode in the, like, the gallery mode where you've seen it isn't very good.
Yeah.
And then there's, like, the various different color schemes of the Zaku, and then there's the white Dingo regular gym. Like, the regular gym can get in white Dingo colors, if you can put it. I know the Goof, the Zaku, the Gundam, and the Jim. I think there was only 4. I think it was 2 for each side, had alternate colors.
Yeah.
Boy, and the Zagok model in that game looked so fucking bad. They didn't know how to fucking model that, dude. It doesn't even look right. It almost looks like the Origin in Zagok. But the Origin wasn't out yet. Like, it's bad. It's possibly the worst Zagok model I've ever seen. It's like a Chinese bootleg Zagok. It really is.
But the funniest part is that it's stupidly hard.
Yeah, because it can shoot both of its beam rifles, or beam guns, while it's walking.
Yep.
so it does double the damage of, like, a gym. Like, because it doesn't have the best power rating, but you can shoot two of them at a time, so it's like, you're gonna stagger people and knock them over all the time. Yeah.
That suit was actually pretty
melee in that game's stupid hard, too.
Yeah.
Because you literally just swing in front of you for, like, 2 feet. You just, like, flail your arm around, and then that's it.
You have to really rapid-fire that fucking triangle button to actually get your suit to do a three-hit combo.
Yeah, and then the mobile suit explosions damage you significantly. Which, that's interesting, but... Yeah, man, that game didn't age well. I have fond memories of it, but Christ.
That game was hard. That game was not age well. I S-ranked everything, but damn, that game was hard.
Same. Nice. But for as short as that game was, they made it hard, so you'd have to keep playing. Because really, after you beat all the mission mode once, there's no reason to play it again. Once you beat the story mode twice, because you unlock the movie mode version, which is just slightly different, there's no reason to play it again. It only has, like, 3 replays in it. Which is a shame. So that's how games used to be back in the day. They were short.
Oh, yeah.
Encounters in Space, I'm going to straight up say, is easily 3 times as long as Grenade Burrow.
Yeah.
Easily. I think just the white base mode is longer than Journey to Jaburo.
Yeah, Journey to Jaburo's story mode only had like 9 missions.
Yeah, and then a couple of them are short as shit.
Yep. Like the first one is just kill 2 Zakus.
Yeah, there's a massive difficulty spike too. Once you get to that third mission in New York, boy.
Yeah, difficulty that one, up. Yeah, that one's not fun.
Just well, really, mission 2, because Char shows up.
Yeah.
You jump from Site 7 all the way to, like, Great Canyon. I can't believe they've kept that translation to Great Canyon instead of Grand Canyon. And New York instead of New York. Like, that one always gets me, too. What I always want to know is, when did the push to change the fight from New York to Seattle start?
Yeah, I think that came in with the movies, and I'm not quite sure why. I think they just, because there's fewer stops on the white base's path, they kind of just took the opportunity to refine it a little bit.
Yeah, because they land it, they do Great Canyon, and then, like, you're going to just skip them flying over the entire continent to get to New York. They're like, oh, we got to look for someplace, like, right here. Seattle.
Mm-hmm.
Because then they go into Asia. Like, the Xeonic Front special animation shows, like, the entire path of the white base, according to the movies. And they drop through orbit, end at Drake Canyon, go up to Seattle, then go up through Alaska, down through Russia, and start heading towards Odessa.
Yeah.
They go through the Middle East for some reason. Like, well, it's more like Turkmenistan. Not really the real Middle East, but pretty much the Middle East. And then they get to Odessa. And then Belfast. And then fucking straight shot to Jaburo. Fucking 45 degree angle, we're going down. Yeah. Yeah, I always thought that was weird. There's such a big disconnect with the movies. Like, it's Seattle now. The S3 point, they call it.
Sorry, I'm so quiet. Benadryl is hitting me a little harder than I expected, so...
Yeah, I think this might be my last one. I'm starting to get into some pain here.
Yeah, good time to quit, then. Because you need to not be in pain, and I don't want to snore on your recording, so...
So, Rob.
Yeah?
Question. What day this week before Friday would you be able to do Maxibus, if at all?
I do not know.
Fair.
Why did you call Friday? What's going on?
I don't want to be busy all weekend.
Ah,
gotcha. Yeah,
I should be fine again Sunday night. Just do a recording, but then pretty much Friday, Saturday, Sunday morning and afternoon will be busy.
I gotcha.
Stays in the transform state.
That's right. That's, egg.
It's kind of cute.
Yeah.
Your roles. Save. Rob, since you're about to pass out, you pick what we pick.
Okay.
Volunteered yourself.
We still have jumped up 10%.
Nice.
Well, yeah, because I think it's not necessarily mission count. It's percentage of what you've done in Peaceful's Roots.
Yeah. I mean, still.
Yeah. You're getting there. You gotta get the 300%. We're getting there. What are we looking at, Rob?
We got mobile suit, warship, mobile armor, and variety.
And you can also choose back out one, Salty. You can also choose anything from there.
Let's go a couple of boxes of variety. I don't know, you know, no specific cost, but just pick something and see what you get.
Music that I cannot play during stream.
Yeah.
Okay, that was not my best point.
No, that's all right.
No, we'll keep going with it. We got two more. Three more, even.
Wow.
Another BGM.
Ooh, come on,
come on.
Neat.
Oh, there you go.
And the art we already had.
That one's a good one.
Oh, dang.
We'll save the rest of
the points. That's fair.
So,
well, all 600 that we can't get really anything else out of? Yes.
Let's see.
Yes, save them, Salty.
Wrong one, were you? Yeah, no, I guess they're all together.
No, it would be down near the bottom.
Yep,
there it is.
There it is.
She plays voice line. Hey, it's Leader Neo-Zeon Vermin, it's Daxus. Consider your options
carefully. Well, this is a good ending screen anyway. People seem to have a hard-on for Haman for whatever reason.
Because she's like the best female character in all of UC. Like, she's like one of the only ones that's actually developed. Like, straight up.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you have, like, Rue and L, but, like, they're side characters versus, like, main antagonists for two series.
Yeah.
But, I want to apologize for being a short one. I'm just kind of not feeling it all. And then Rob's also passing out over here, too.
And I'm okay.
Yeah. Jacob's all right, though, so, yeah. I want to thank you guys for watching. Make sure you come back Tuesday for whatever recording I decided to throw out. I'm not too sure which one yet. And, I hope you guys check out Rob's channel. Jacob doesn't do anything yet, but I hope you guys have a fantastic Monday. Talk to you guys later.
Take care.
Have a great week.